Hey, it's Steven with Electrek, and today we're gonna take a look at the Pave BK built right here in Brooklyn.
The BK is a fully street-legal motorbike with a top speed of 30 miles per hour and a range of up to 50 miles. The bike is powered by a brushless 3,000-watt rear hub motor that makes for a silent ride. As for the battery, the bike uses a 50.4-volt 39.2-amp-hour battery that is 25 pounds and is fully removable for charging. To get a better idea of the bike, we went over to their site in Brooklyn where co-founder Nico Nagel was able to give us more of an in-depth look.
Thanks for coming by. I'm Nico. So my brother and I started a company together in 2019. And when we started out, our concept was to create something that falls in between the e-bikes and the e-motorcycles.
Okay.
So taking the good aspects of an e-bike, so it's lightweight, intuitive, really easy to ride.
Yeah.
And then combining that with the good aspect of motorcycles, right? The fun of it, the utility, so you can bring two people, you can have extra storage space, and the idea is kind of that you have the lightness and easy to ride feeling of
exactly
a bicycle, but you get the utility of a motorcycle.
Are you guys planning on selling extra batteries?
Yeah, we'll be selling extra batteries and then also different types of chargers. So every bike comes with the standard overnight charger, mm-hmm. but we will have a fast charger available. Because with the fast charger, you can get up to 80% within an hour. So if you bring the fast charger to, cafe, you drink a quick coffee, check your emails, and you got a full battery again, you know? So the bike comes, so it has GPS and LTE connectivity.
Okay.
So when you leave your bike outside, you can lock it. And if somebody, say, tries to steal the bike, we have a wake on shake functionality, so the bike will wake up if it's being moved and the owner is not nearby, and that's when the GPS will start tracking it, and you will get on your phone, you will get a notification that somebody that's not you is messing with your bike or trying to move your bike. So those are like the main security features. And then on top, the way you lock and unlock the bike. So when you purchase a Pave, you also get a digital version of the bike in form of a non-fungible token. So that makes it more secure because you're gonna be the only person that has this token. It stores your VIN number, it stores your title, it stores all the information like odometer. So you can think of it as a digital title that's also your key. So if somebody tries to steal steals the bike and then tries to resell it, mm-hmm. they'll never be able to prove that it's their own bike because they're not going to have ownership over that key, and they won't be able to unlock it either. We're planning on releasing that in the next couple months, but the idea is that you as an owner have the ability to share your bike with other people on the network and have the ability to monetize your vehicle by renting it out to someone. And the way it would work is you set up a smart rental contract with, let's say I want to rent my bike to you. I find you on the network. I say, okay, I'm going to give you permission to ride my bike between the hours of 3 and 6, only on Wednesdays of this month. And then on those days, during those times, you'll have access to the bike. And in the contract, I can specify, okay, I want you to pick up the bike here and drop it off at a different location or at the same location. And if you don't do that, if you don't follow the rules of this contract, you have to pay a fee, basically, like a deposit that you put down before.
So owners dictate the price?
Yes.
Owners have
full control over the pricing.
And since no review is complete without a test ride, we decided to put on our helmets and hit the road.
Whoa. Super silent from the hub motor. You feel much higher up on these.
Yeah.
It's easier to maneuver like really quickly.
Yeah, and that's also the nice thing that you have that like the weight is on the top.
Right? Yeah.
Now you may have noticed by now that the bike does not have rear suspension, and that's because they decided to go with the really cushioned seat instead. Overall, I think they did a really good job with the seat here. The ride was fairly comfortable, and I didn't even really notice the lack of rear suspension. For the front, they have single crown inverter suspension forks with 60 millimeters of travel. The bike comes with three modes, which are Eco, Normal, and Sport, with Sport being the optimal performance and letting you get an acceleration from 0 to 30 miles per hour in 3.7 seconds. The bike also comes with a Boost mode that lets you get the max acceleration possible, and while the bike is really fun to rip around town, I think where it really shines is the utility. With the seat being very high up and the battery being tucked in right underneath that seat, the bike comes with a lot of space underneath. I was told that the storage space underneath would be able to carry up to 2 extra batteries, and while probably more practical to carry the fast charger, it is really nice to know that it's that big. In addition to the middle of the bike, there's also the option to add things to the sides and to the back of the bike with the proper accessories. As for the braking system, the BK comes with motorcycle grade brakes as well as the regenerative brakes. The bike has a wheelbase of 1,220mm, a ground clearance of 180mm, and a weight of 101 pounds without the battery, which I believe weighs 25 pounds. Overall, the BK was a blast to ride, but I think the strength of this bike comes in the utility and design. I love the idea that new owners are going to be able to rent these out independently via the blockchain, and while I can definitely see myself in a new city renting one of these out for a week, I do have to say that the technology is still pretty young, and I'd be curious to see just how practical the technology ends up being in the real world, and if this is going to have a lot of bumps in the road, or is going to take off. If you made it to the end, thank you so much for watching, and if you haven't already, make sure to give us a like and subscribe.